Unfortunately, we see it every year in college football. There's a player with a lot of athletic potential, and he decides to declare for the draft. Many believe that it's 50-50 that he's even ready for the draft, and in most cases, it ends up being a mistake. We do see some cases where a player who didn't do a whole lot in college becomes great in the NFL, but as I said, most of the time, it doesn't work out. In today's video, I want to talk about an Oregon player who has all the potential in the world to be a star, but I don't think he's ready for the NFL, and honestly, I think he's making a major mistake for his career, and we're going to talk about who he is, his journey, why I think that, and overall, my thoughts on this player. But right before we get into it, nearly 80% of you guys are not subscribed to the channel, and we can do better than that. Plus, we're on the road to 100K, so I really need your help, so be sure to hit that subscribe button, smash that like button for the algorithm, turn on post notifications, and let me know another player I can take a look at for the 2022 NFL Draft. Now, let's get started. So, you're probably wondering who the subject of today's video is, and it is none other than Oregon wide receiver Devin Williams. At one point, he was considered a five-star recruit and the top athlete in his class, but things have not gone according to plan in his college career, but he's going to try to salvage it and make it to the NFL. Let's go back in time and meet Devon Williams, though. Devon grew up in California and later went to Antelope Valley High School in the city of Lancaster, California. By the year 2017, he was seen as one of the best athletes in the nation and blossomed into a five-star player. He caught 72 passes for 1,164 yards with 13 touchdowns as a senior there, and according to Max Preps, he also led his team to an 11-3 record and played on both sides of the ball. He was one of those West Coast athletes, and like a lot of players, named Oregon his leader in the recruitment. But then a major curveball was thrown. He was set to commit to the Ducks, but Willie Taggart jumped ship to Florida State after 1 year, and this made him reconsider everything. USC now began to emerge as his favorite in his recruitment, and he eventually chose the Trojans over the Ducks on National Signing Day. Shock and disappointment was a good way to describe how Ducks fans felt, but they would get a chance to have him back later. Here's what scouts had to say. Quote, at 6'4" and 200 pounds, it doesn't take Williams long to stand out on tape. Not only is he electric in the open field, but he has quick hips that allow him to break on the ball with remarkable ease for a player of his size. USC brings in tons of wide receiver talent, but he was expected to play right away, and with his insane athleticism, he didn't care where he played. He said, quote, I honestly don't have a preference between offense or defense. I'll play anywhere. I just want to play. Whatever gets me on the field fastest is what I want to play. I just love football, so wherever my team needs me, I will do it. He was considered the best deep ball threat in the class, and USC had arguably the best duo in the class of Amon-Ra St. Brown and Devon in the same class. According to 24/7 Sports, Williams was a four-star recruit, the number 6 wide receiver, and the 40th best player in the class of 2018. So as a true freshman in 2018, Williams caught passes in 2 total games. The best performance would be a 3-reception, 77-yard, 1-touchdown performance against Oregon State, but overall, he would barely play as a freshman, and I can't help but think USC was on thin ice for him already. He did decide to come back as a sophomore, though. It ended up being a logjam at receiver, though, as he was stuck behind Michael Pittman, Tyler Vaughns, Velus Jones, Drake London, and Amon-Ra St. Brown. That is why he only played in 1 game in 2019 against Stanford before he would decide to leave in the middle of the year. He caught 5 passes for 98 yards and a touchdown in 2 seasons, and he would need a change in scenery if he wanted to live up to his hype. So where would he go? He entered the portal and was supposed to visit both Oregon State and Oregon, but he would later cancel his trip to Eugene and chose to commit to the Beavers. This was a huge signing for Jonathan Smith, but it ended up blowing up in their face. The Oregon team even said he was a Beaver and he was listed on the roster, but it was later revealed that he had not made his decision yet and chose the Ducks instead. This was extremely strange, and this was early warning signs that he could seemingly not make a decision. An Oregon writer had this to say about the impact of Williams, though. Quote, there's absolutely no debating that Williams is an alluring target in the passing game who presents matchup problems given his tremendous blend of size and athletic ability. Though he was never able to quite crack USC's deep rotation at receiver, the path figures to be a little clearer for Williams at Oregon. While Oregon has some talented wide receiver playmakers over the last few years, they haven't been known as the best passing offense, but hopefully Williams will get a chance to change that. Combining his talents with Johnny Johnson, Brian Addison, and their first-year offensive coordinator Joe Moorhead, things were expected to be fun to watch in the passing game going into 2020. Who the heck would be the quarterback, though? Justin Herbert was now gone. It was going to come down to Tyler Shough and Boston College transfer Anthony Brown, and Shough was definitely better for his passing potential. We all know Shough won the job and was average at best. The first two games were very slow for Williams, but then he picked it up. Against UCLA, he broke out and showed the world what his ceiling was. He had 6 catches for 123 yards and a touchdown, and Mario Cristobal had this to say. Quote, I'm really proud of Devon, and I feel like he's another guy that's just kind of getting going now. We feel like he's going to be an excellent football player, and the sky's the limit. He followed up that game with 4 catches for 101 yards and a touchdown in their loss to Oregon State, but he showed out and proved he was a playmaker who could do damage. He did not register a stat in the Pac-12 championship game against USC, but he did catch 2 passes in their loss to Iowa State in the Fiesta Bowl. He finished the season with 15 receptions for 286 yards and 2 touchdowns in his first year as a Duck. Right now, he's nowhere near the NFL radar. 2021, he would have to have a big year. So how did he do? Williams would end up becoming the top receiver on the team, despite not really having that great of performances. He would catch his first touchdown in a win over Colorado, which was also his second best receiving game of the year. He caught another touchdown in their win over Washington, a touchdown in their loss to Utah, and then he had 6 catches for 110 yards and a touchdown in a win over Oregon State. As we know, the Ducks would end up going to the Pac-12 championship game, and with 2 losses, they were eliminated from the college football playoff. That didn't matter, as they didn't show up. The number 17 Utes won 38-10, and this would be the final game of Devon's career. He ended up catching 35 passes for 557 yards and 4 touchdowns. That screams numbers for an above-average starting wide receiver, not an NFL draft pick. I'm sorry, but with those kind of numbers, there's no way Devon will get drafted based on that alone. So there has to be a catch, right? Well, the guy is a super good athlete, and he did start to turn it on more so towards the end of the year, but in my eyes, I just don't understand his decision to leave. He could have came back next year with the new coaching staff and the new offensive coordinator and a new quarterback and maybe put up even better numbers and maybe even become a day 1 or day 2 draft pick. Unfortunately, now I think his ceiling is day 3, and unless they think they can unlock some sort of untapped potential, I just don't understand the move. He's had a very underwhelming career so far, and would have an opportunity to better himself in the coming years, so why risk throwing it all away now? Well, he is a very religious person, as in my research, he credits God a lot, and as a religious person myself, if he is in his process and thinks it is time, then I will support it and I will root for him. In terms of on paper though, this is a somewhat crazy and mind-boggling decision. Maybe something went on behind the scenes, or maybe he is getting data that we don't have. As I look at scouting reports, most say he is a day 3 to undrafted pick, but we're just gonna have to wait and see what happens. What do you guys think though? If you're an Oregon fan, what do you think of Devon Williams? Who is another player that you think should not have declared early? And overall, what's another draft prospect I can take a look at for this year's draft? Be sure to let me know your thoughts down in the comment section. Smash that like button if you want to support today's video. Subscribe if you're new, and check out all my other videos on the end screen. I hope to see you guys again soon, but until next time, peace.